Uh-oh, Jordan, definitely want to catch a snake. You see anything down there?
Let's see what he really looks like. Oh my God. Go right in the back of the head. Get him, get him. There you go, don't let go.
All right, you guys, welcome back to Blake's Exotic Animal Ranch. Today, what we are gonna be doing is we're gonna be heading out into the Everglades and we're gonna go capture, hopefully, some pythons out in the Everglades, some invasive species. But before that happens, we are waiting for Paul, Jalen, Jordan, and Jacob to meet up with us before we go out there. It's evening here, so it's about to get dark very, very soon, and that's about the best time to go capture all different types of native reptiles and invasive species out in the Everglades. And literally the Everglades, you guys, is down the street. But we're gonna go a little farther north, a little south, who knows, go many, many hours into the night, just hopefully find some big animals, big snakes, especially Burmese pythons. But before that starts off, you guys, the fish needed to get fed, and I thought, why not show you guys the fish before we head out into the Everglades? And yeah, let's do it. But first off, platinum redtail becoming a freaking monster. Scarface, my black diamond stingray doing great. My smaller black diamond stingray doing is great. What else is here? And we have the three albino arowanas. They're doing absolutely amazing just as well. Look at them. Pretty good, pretty cool. So right here we have a bunch of defrosted shiners right here. And we're gonna drop a few of them in there. And I know they are hungry. So let's back up a little bit and drop them on this side. So the current will bring them over here and drop them low down there. See what happens. There we go. Bam, that guy just ate them up quick. And hopefully a bunch of them will sink down. Scarface is probably gonna get some right now. He's gonna smell it around. There he goes. Douche. Heck yeah, look at that. That is so awesome. And we went down for some more over here. There you go, there you go. Not too much action, but once that red tail gets those little tentacles and starts smelling them in the air, it's game over. All right, I'm gonna get a little bit more brain over here. Break some up. And you guys, everyone's been asking, why have I not moved anything into the building yet that we already purchased and that we got here on the ranch? The reason why is because we do not have any electricity inside of there yet. Once I get all that processed and put together and everything, then we're gonna start moving things in. That's gonna probably take about a month or so, but it's a process, it's step by step by step, because there's so many things happening here on the ranch all the time, so put those post notifications on. Drop that down. I broke some of the fish up so it'll sink a little better. Here he comes. Smaller black diamond eating him up. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. He's a monster. It's an absolute monster. Throw a little bit more down for him. Everyone is eating up a storm. And we will be getting some more monster fish very, very soon, but I do not want to get anything yet, of course, until I have that building set up. So then, because I have some very large tanks inside of the garage as well that have to go over there, and I also have some very large pool ponds just for temporary enclosures until I make very nice fish tanks, fiberglass tanks with viewing panels, things of that sort. But everything is temporary until we do it from another, like, it's like step one, step two. We always do step one, step two, and then it's complete and finished. But what we're gonna do right now is they're about to get here. They just texted me, I just saw that. And they're about to pull up in just a few seconds. So we're gonna meet you guys out in the Everglades in just a few seconds. It's about to get dark, so by the time we get out there, it's gonna be dark out there. And I will see you guys with all my goofy friends out in the Everglades. All right, you guys, so today's been a real long day here at the ranch, but we decided to go out into the Everglades and go herping. And herping is pretty much looking for reptiles and different invasive species of reptiles here in the Everglades. We're going down this very long white road, and I'm here with my buddy Jordan, Jacob Fetter, Paul Caffaro, and my boy Jalen that is driving the truck right now. And what's up, Paul?
Hey.
There's Jacob. There's Jordan. We're out here. And I mean, we're just looking around. We're cruising the roads, looking for different things out in the Everglades. And we're gonna keep you guys updated and see if we find any reptiles here in the Everglades. All right, you guys, so we just got out of the truck, and yeah, the truck wasn't really working out too good. So we have five guys here. Like, we got a bunch of us, and Jalen's in the truck still hiding because he's a little scared of snakes. And we're gonna go literally look around for some snakes. There's a high chance we're gonna find the snake because it's been raining a lot and it's really, really, really humid. So let's go look around and find some snakes, you guys. Hopefully we find a Burmese python, water snake. I have no idea, but let's go look around and find a snake. What?
Frogs.
Oh. Oh. You all right?
Yeah.
That was Jalen. All right. But I know Jordan definitely wants to catch a snake. You see anything down there? Jacob just caught a bug, so that's pretty awesome. We caught something at least. That's good. But we're going to keep on looking around, and hopefully we'll be able to find. What did you get?
We found a little
lightning God. Bug. A lightning bug.
Can we see it? Look at that
thing. My God, it's glowing. It's awesome. It's perfect.
It's amazing.
And Jalen, all right. Thank you for that, buddy. Nope, don't want to eat it. All right, let's look for a snake, you guys.
So we're just looking around. We got back into the truck because we were walking way too much. We couldn't find anything. But it's been a long night, you guys. Many, many hours of cruising. And I don't know. Let's see. You guys see anything? What's up?
Whoa, what is that?
Where? Oh, crap. Let's go check it. Yeah. Let's go.
Yeah.
But we literally saw the freaking glow with the lights.
Just look at him moving in and
we haven't
out
even
of
touched
grass.
Him yet, and he's literally still here.
So he doesn't even care that we're here right now. He is just cruising through the grass looking for a meal.
Definitely.
He's got to be, what, like 10 feet, 11 feet?
I don't even know. It's bigger than my freaking... What's my snake's name at home? Sunkiss.
I forgot my snake's name. So guys, this is the moment we've been waiting for all night.
Literally.
We've been out here for hours and it's end of the night and we just so happen to find this python.
He's kind of cold. He's not moving too much.
Yeah. It's weird. Really hot today.
I tapped him in the butt.
So guys, woo! Oh, he's mad now. We touched him.
Oh yeah.
So we're going to go right up here, right behind his head. He knows we're here.
Let's get him out into the light a little bit though.
Okay.
Let's see what he really looks like. Oh my God.
You guys can see him slithering.
That is a nice snake. I hate that we have to euthanize them so much.
Man, it's horrible. But they are not supposed to be here.
They are invasives.
These guys are a super invasive species. These guys are killing almost all of our native animals. They're killing alligators, they're killing deer. So unfortunately, he does have to be removed from the environment since he is not supposed to be here. He is from Asia. Sadly, where they are from in Asia, they're a threatened species. Actually, I think, Blake, didn't they just get on the endangered list?
They did.
So in their own native homeland, they are an endangered species. But here, they're not. Here, they're a problem.
Make sure you guys are following Jacob on his YouTube.
Subscribe, guys.
There you go.
So we're going to go up to him. We're going to grab him right behind his head.
Yo, I think my boy Jordan wants to grab him. Jordan, I think you can get it.
I think I'll let Jacob grab him.
Jordan, come on.
I think I'll let Jacob grab him.
Come on, Jordan. Nah, you got to do it for the YouTube for Blake's Exotic Animal Ranch. Bro, ranch fam. Grab that boy.
I think I'll let Jacob grab him.
All right,
we're going to go right behind the head.
Got him.
Oh, yeah. He's mad.
He's fired up.
He's probably gonna musk all over me.
Yeah, that's not yummy.
I wanna hold him down. Oh no. Look at this guy.
He's a big guy.
Oh, he's trying to wrap me up now.
Alrighty.
Okay.
It's a nice berm though.
Oh man.
At least we got one for tonight. Yeah. That's freaking awesome.
Beauty. Take a look at him. Who wants to touch him? Who wants to get their hands on this beautiful guy?
Yeah, Jordan. Touch him.
Come on, Jordan.
He's all right.
It's a beautiful snake. It's crazy how they live in South Florida now. I've done this way back in the day, but like, look at this now. This is so cool.
Oh, yeah.
How big do you think this is?
Got to be like 10, 11 feet. But
like 3 years old, maybe?
3 years old, yeah.
Yeah. A
couple summers ago. I actually want you guys to come take a look at his teeth. Look at those teeth. I don't know if you could see it that well. These teeth are serrated backwards, so when they grab the prey can't get loose.
Yo, we can't see you, Jalen.
Hold up, I got this.
That's awesome. That's a nice snake.
Beautiful specimen.
Heck yeah.
He's actually, you're right, he's feeling, Blake. He's a little bit cold.
A little cold, that's why he wasn't really moving too much.
He's not moving, he's not. When you get these snakes, when they're hot, man, they'll put up a crazy fight. This guy is actually pretty mellow. He got mad for a couple seconds, but he's great now. It's actually one of the calmest berms that I've caught.
Heck yeah. Like I said, it's probably cold. He's probably in a cool spot. Cold rain.
Sure.
Messed him up, cooled him down. But I mean, that is awesome. Definitely awesome.
Mm-hmm.
What's up, Paul? You got anything to say to this?
He likes the trees, I think.
Yeah, Paul's behind the camera.
Paul, you're supposed to be filming turtles. For Jacob. It's over here.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry.
There you go.
Yeah. No, I was just showing how much of a beautiful area he's living in.
As much as I loved animals, I do accept the reality that they're not supposed to be here. A lot of people want to rehome them, but sadly, you can't rehome 100,000 mean snakes that are full of nasty parasites. So we are going to euthanize him. And the snake will be put to good use. We'll use his skins, we'll use his fat to make soap, and Yeah, we're gonna eat them.
Where are they from?
You guys down for a python fry?
You know us, we eat anything. We eat anything.
I ain't eating a python.
I'm not eating a python. You eating a python?
We'll make some python tacos.
No, I'm not eating a python.
All right, we're good?
Nope.
All right.
Ranch fan people don't like snakes.
But we are gonna skin them.
All right, you guys, so everything that Jacob just said was 100% true because that's why who brought me out here. Oh my goodness, he just dropped the snake again.
Yeah, he's on the move. He's on the prowl.
He's coming towards me. But we're about to bag him up.
Put the light on him, put the light on him.
Paul.
Yo.
Put the light on him.
I need the Paul over here, light. There you go.
Let's do this. I wanna get some.
All right, you guys, so we're about to bag up this snake so that we could take him to another place.
Wait, let's get this thumbnail right here.
They're gonna humanely euthanize him, but yeah. We're gonna put him in the bag and I'll see you guys back at the ranch. See you guys then.
All right, you guys. So Jordan decided to, he wanted to try to catch a wild berm on his own. Jacob put him down real quick. And Jordan, yo, you better get this boy. You better hold on to him. He's gonna get you.
I'm gonna get him.
Let's go, come on. Catch a wild berm for your first time. I've done it before, now it's your turn. Go right in the back of the head. Get him. There you go, don't let go. Oh, he's getting himself. You're good. Don't let go.
Don't do it.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, boy. There you go, you got yourself a wild berm. Pretty awesome.
Let me get this.
All right, guys, we just pulled over to the side after we caught that big berm, and yeah, look at this.
Guy was going across the street, you know, had to get out and stop him.
You got it?
We should probably move too.
Yeah, we're about to die.
But then, thankfully, boy, Jalen right here, give me my freaking handshake, thank you. He saw this little corn snake right here. Pretty awesome. Look at this guy, saying what's up to us now. Yep.
Look at it.
How are you, buddy? We're letting go of the snake. Look at this, you guys. Beautiful corn snake right here that we found in the Everglades. Just pulled over off to the side of the road. Saw him, saved him so he didn't get run over. And we're about to release him just now. Pretty awesome little guy. What is this, you think, like a yearling maybe?
Yeah.
Not too good at my snakes. I'm learning from Jacob, but.
Pretty awesome little guy.
Cool. You want to release him? You want me to release him?
I'll release him.
All right, cool.
Let's put him down.
Awesome.
Get him out of the road.
Yeah,
keep on going.
All right, you guys. We just pulled up onto a gator. Jacob, keep talking.
So this gator right here is a big, probably like 9.5, 10 foot gator. Sadly, he did get hit by a car. You can see his skull is completely cracked open here. He's got a big chunk missing from his skin here. This guy's probably 12, 15 years old.
Definitely. And we actually have the markings. Like you can see the markings.
Yeah, this is
right
where
there. Hit here and probably somebody pulled him to the side of the road. That's upsetting, but I mean, I guess that's the reason why there's too many people in this world.
Yep.
But yeah.
Poor animal.
That was a big monster.
I'm just picturing where that car went after it hit something like that.
Yeah, that's actually insane. That's a big gator. Well, now the vultures are gonna eat him.
Oh, there's a car right here, Blake, in the bush.
Oh, there's a what?
The car over there in the bush. You see
the car's over there?
Yeah, it's right
there. No, that's okay. I don't care about the car.
I don't want him to swipe my door. It's wide open.
But
look at that.
That's insane, you guys.
Oh, yeah.
Wow, big old gator. What do you think about this, Jordan?
I think it's a big one.
To biggin.
I kind of want to ride it. Don't touch it.
You guys, so it's next day here back on Blake's Exotic Animal Ranch. And as you guys saw, we were able to actually catch, after about 3 to 4 hours of straight driving the roads, looking through the trees, looking through the bushes, knowing spots that there's been a lot of high activity of people catching berms in those certain spots, we actually were able to find about a 10-foot Burmese python, which was pretty freaking awesome. Every single time I've been out there, I've actually pretty much always caught in one. The biggest one I ever caught was a few of my friends, and it was about a 14-foot Burmese python, and it was way back in one of my first videos I ever posted. But and then also, you guys saw, we saw that red rat snake. We caught one of those as well, a little small one that we saved from the road. And then as well, we saw a giant giant alligator that got hit by a car, which was absolutely insane. You saw that it had like a big mark on its head and a big mark on its tail. But I mean, that alligator was massive, and it must have got hit by a freaking semi or something, which really sucks because that animal has lived for who knows how many years, probably 20, 30, 40 years, and one car came by, he was just crossing the road trying to go to another beautiful part of the Everglades, and it got hit by a car, which absolutely sucks. But so we're here back on the ranch, and I'm gonna show you guys a little bit of how all the ducks, chickens, goats, donkey, how everybody is doing, you guys. So let's go check a look. All right, you guys, so I don't know if you could tell, but all day today, I just came out now because I need to film a video for you guys, but I don't know what happened. I guess from being out all night, it was raining, it was muggy out, I don't know what happened, but I got freaking sick, you guys. It's horrible, but whatever. We don't stop here on the ranch, keep on going. But everyone's doing absolutely great, you guys. The ducks are doing great,
The chickens are doing great. Snickers is doing amazing. Everyone's doing absolutely great, except my grass right there kind of got beat up from the machines from the damn barn. But whatever, we'll fix that later. But look at everybody, you guys. Everyone's doing absolutely beautiful. And then we got right over there. Here, let me show you guys real quick. We got two beautiful Plymouth Barter Rock chickens. It's those zebra-looking ones right there. One of my buddies, Dylan, brought them over. He had them at his house. Couldn't take care of them anymore, and he dropped them off here at the ranch. Only really close friends, they have something, I'll take them in. But I can't take everything in because there's so many animals out there in the world. That is the reason why some people need to make sure that people take care of the animals for the whole entire life. You got to make sure that when you purchase something, that you're going to keep it for the whole entire life, the whole entire time it survives. That's the main reason why there's so many invasive snakes out in the wild, because that's how it started. People were having them as pets. They stayed small. They thought there was a ball python or something like that, and they grew to 6 foot in 1 year, and then after 2 years they're 8 foot, and then it turned into a giant snake that was eating almost goat sizes. So that's the reason why they're not the best pets, and that's the reason why there's so many invasive snakes out there in the Everglades, and now they produce very, very well out in the Everglades. And look at that, you guys. A lot of people are asking me, where's Moore's been at? Moore's has been here without any problems. We'll do an update video on her very soon. She's been absolutely great. She's been doing awesome here on the ranch, you guys. But let me think. If you guys haven't seen that video, make sure you check that video out. Put those post notifications on, you guys. And then for today's post notification shout out is going to Todd. He says, get a huge enclosure and get the opposite sex. What he is talking about is Petrie. A lot of people in the comments of Petrie's video, if you guys haven't seen, it was my last recent video. A lot of people are asking, get the opposite sex so Petrie has a friend. Well, Petrie is a neutered male and he is my pet. He will be, he's pet to me. He's bonded to me. If I got another one, they'd be bonded to each other and then be very, very hard to interact with them and do videos with him. So, you're good. The no goats are peeing on you, don't worry. Hey, relax. Things always happen here on the ranch, you guys. But yeah, so Petrie is gonna be staying in that cage by himself, and my friends, family, we all go into that enclosure all the time, almost twice a day, feed him, hang out with him, interact with him all the time, and I'm making him friendly throughout with everybody so that if I'm not here, he's friends with somebody else, so he always has somebody to bond with if I wasn't here. So that's the reason why we haven't had somebody else. That's the reason why we haven't gotten another Kinkajou, and we've only had him now for about 3 weeks. Put another positive comment down below to get shouted out on Blake's Exotic Animal Ranch, you guys. And I hope you guys enjoyed today's video here on the ranch. Everyone is doing absolutely great. The barn will be getting updated more very, very soon. We'll have a lot more things going with that very soon, but it's a lot of money and I don't have the money for that right now. But I'll see you guys in an upcoming video, guys, and peace out, everybody.